Dear friends, assalamu alaikum. I am your host Abdul Qadir Malla, and today our topic is present continuous tense. So let's start. So present continuous tense is such kind of a tense which shows that subject is doing some work continuously in present time. That is called present continuous tense, or it shows continuity of a verb. For example, if I say I am teaching present continuous tense. Now you can see that I am working continuously. So in this way it is present continuous tense. And you are watching my video. Now you are continuously watching my video. So that is also a present continuous tense. Now let's learn the main points of present continuous tense. Is, am, and are the helping verbs of this tense. Is used with he, she, it, boy, Ali, or singular subjects. And am is used only with I. Are is used with we, you, they, boys, are plural subjects. Now you can see that is used only with singular subjects, while the are is used only with plural subjects, and am is only used with first person singular subjects, subject I. But there a question arises that you is sometimes used as a singular and also sometimes as a plural. So can we use you with is? No. So I will say to you, no, because you always takes plural helping verb. Got it? Now, and fourth, are in form of the main verb is used in present continuous tense, and there are also some rules that how to add ing with the main verb. So let's start. First of all, there is a general rule that we have to add ing with the main verb to form forth a ing form. Like if a word is read, then what we have to do? We have to add ing with read to form forth a ing form. Then it will become reading. Like speak, and we have to add what? Ing to form fourth R ing form. Speaking, a word ends with E, then remove the E and add ing, like save. So now we have to remove E, then this will become saving, or take, then it will become taking. But there are also some exceptions that if a word ends with a double E, Y-E, R O E, then we will not remove E, but directly we will add ing, like see. Now you can see that the word ends with double E, so now we have to add directly ing. Then this will become sing, or die, so we will add directly ing. Dying, or to, like, so we will directly add ing. There is also another exception that if a word ends with IE, then we will remove IE into Y, and after that we will add ing, like tie. So we have to remove IE and then add Y, like this, tie. After that add ing, time, or lie. So we will write line. Rule number 2. If a word ends with W, X or Y, then we will directly add ing, like this. Giro. Now a W is in the end of the sentence, so we will directly add ing. So this will become growing or mix. So we will add directly ing, then this will become mixing or pry. So we will directly add ing, then this will become prying. Now point number 3, that if a word has a single syllable and ends with a consonant, vowel and consonant, then we will double the last consonant letter, like katte. So you can see that first of all is consonant and then vowel and then consonant. So we will double the last consonant and then after that add ing, like this. Cut, cutting, or set. So this will become sitting. Point number 4. If a word has two syllable and it ends with a consonant, vowel and consonant, then we will also add the last consonant and after that add ing form. That means double syllable, like this. Add mit. So now you can see this, we say add and mit, these are two syllable and stress is on the last syllable, so we will double the T, then this will become admitting, or we can say commit. So we will double the T because there are two syllable, we say commit, commit, so that's why there is more stress, so we will double the last letter, so this will become commenting. 5. If a word has two syllable and it has no stress on the last syllable, or the syllables have stress on the equal basis, then we will not double the last letter, like this. Not stress on the last, not stress on the last syllable, like this. Target. So you can see that tar and gate are two syllable and both are of equal rank, or we can say that a tar has a little bit more stress, so this will become targeting. Now we are not doubling the last let consonant. Then visit, so it has also two syllable, we say visit. So you can see that stress is not on the last syllable, so we will not double the last and directly add ing form, like visiting. Point number 6, if a word ends with C, then we have to add king after the C to form fourth or ing form, like panic. So we will say pen king or mimic, so we will say mimicking. The most important points of present continuous tense. एंड यू मस्ट नो दैट फोर्थ आर इंग फॉर्म ऑफ द मेन वर्ब इज यूज्ड एट लीस्ट सिक्स टेंसेज लाइक ऑल कंटिन्यूस टेंसेज. Let's learn the formation of present continuous tense. First of all, we will learn about affirmative sentence. In the affirmative sentence, first of all, we will use subject and then helping verb according to the subject, then main verb, fourth aring form, after that object or complement according to the sentence. For example, if I say he, so he is a sending a gift. So first of all, I have used subject, then helping verb according to the subject, then a main verb, fourth form, and then object. Now we will change it into negative. So what is negative sentence? A sentence which shows negative sense, that is called negative sentence. First of all, we have to use subject and then helping verb, after that not at the third number, then fourth form of the main verb, and then object, then full stop. So we will write he, because he is our subject. Then helping verb is he is, and then not at the third number, he is not, and then main verb sending, he is not sending, and then object a gift. So this is our negative sentences. Now let's change it into interrogative. For changing it into interrogative, first of all, we will use helping verb, then subject, after that main verb, fourth aring form, after that object, and then interrogative symbol. Now which is our helping verb? Is. So we will use is, then subject he is he, and then main verb sending is he sending, after that object a gift, then interrogative symbol, is he sending a gift. So this is the way for changing a sentence into interrogative, interrogative, negative, and negative. Now this is the exercise which you have to solve. What you have to do? You have to make fourth R ing forms by adding ing. And you have also learned the rules for making fourth form. So the word is shake, and other is set, and then fly, and then flow, after that fix, and then happen, after that free, after that dig, and then prefer, after that listen. Now you have to form fourth form of these main words. Thank you.